Hey, Scott Becker here with MetalCloak. Today we're going to be installing the baller joints for the JK Wrangler. Baller joints offer the best features and combine them with top quality materials to create a replacement ball joint set that is unrivaled. This is the only ball joint that is fully sealed, captured, upper and lower load bearing, adjustable, on Jeep rebuildable, and made in the USA. So before we do the installation, let's head over to MetalCloakConstructions.com and print out the instructions and read through them completely. Once we understand what we're getting into and we are certain that we have all the necessary skills and tools, only then should we start in on the installation. Now let's go down to the shop and get started. Our Jeep is already in a safe location and ready to be worked on, so we're gonna verify that all the parts listed on the instructions page are accounted for before taking apart our Jeep. Looks like we're good to go. Using a floor jack, raise the driver's side wheel just off the ground to be removed. Support the axle with a locking type jack stand. Remove the wheel. Remove the steering linkage with a 21mm wrench or deep socket and tie rod separator. Using a 21mm socket, remove the caliper bracket and caliper as an assembly from the knuckle. Remove the rotor. Using a 5mm Allen key, remove the ABS sensor from the wheel hub. Remove the axle assembly. Remove cotter pins from the ball joint spindles. Using a 22mm socket or wrench, remove the retaining nut from the upper and loosen the lower ball joint. Leave the lower nut on a few threads to catch the knuckle from falling when the ball joint spindle releases from the knuckle. Remove the knuckle from the C of the axle housing. This can usually be achieved by tapping or hitting with a ball peen hammer on the knuckle around the outside of the ball joint spindle. Use caution not to damage the knuckle. Using a ball joint tool, remove the upper and lower ball joints from the axle housing C. Depending on the type of tool used, it may be required to remove the upper before the lower or vice versa. Degrease and wire brush the ID of the ball joint socket in the axle housing. Remove the red anodized aluminum cap and lock nut from the housing. Do not use the lock nut to draw the housing up through the hole. Using a ball joint press, press in the MetalCloak upper ball joint, orientating the load bearing flange, the lip that wraps around 180 degrees, to the outside. Once seated, locate the bottom side of the lock nut with thread relief. Install the lock nut until it contacts the axle housing. We recommend using tape on the inside of the wrench latch to help prevent marring of the red anodized surface of the aluminum nut. Using a 2-inch wrench, secure the lock nut. This will only require a slight amount of force with the wrench. Get ready to install the lower ball joint from the bottom up. Before pressing in the ball joint, make sure the grease fitting is not installed and rotate the housing so that the grease port is facing rearward. Do not orient the grease port to the inside or the fitting will not clear the seat for installation. Use caution to be sure the ball joint cup is going in square and smoothly into the seat. Press till fully seated. Once seated, install the lower ball joint grease fitting with a flathead screwdriver. Then use a grease gun. Fill with grease until a slight amount exits the seal at the spindle. Install the supplied 14mm castle nut on the lower spindle to hold the knuckle in place. Using a 22mm socket, torque to factory specs to seat the taper of the spindle into the knuckle. Advance the nut to the next slot in the castle nut that aligns with the hole in the spindle and install the cotter pin. Install the supplied 14mm castle nut on the upper spindle and using a 22mm socket, torque to factory specs. Advance the nut to the next slot in the castle nut that aligns with the hole in the spindle and install the cotter pin. Carefully slide the unit bearing and axle shaft assembly into the knuckle and axle housing. Using a 5mm Allen key, install the ABS sensor from the bearing assembly. Install the rotor. Using a 21mm impact socket, reinstall the caliper bracket and caliper as an assembly to the knuckle. Install the steering linkage with a 21mm wrench or deep socket. Install the tire and wheel. Lower the Jeep to the ground. snug the lower ball joint tensioner with the included laser cut spanner wrench. Install the set screw using a 3/32 Allen wrench. Using a 9/32 socket and a 3/4 inch wrench, install the upper ball joint grease fitting. Then use a grease gun. Fill with grease until a slight amount exits the seal at the spindle. Tighten the upper ball joint preload nut with a 3/4 inch wrench until resistance is felt. Install the set screw using a 3/32 Allen wrench. Install the aluminum cap hand tight till the O-ring seals against the housing. It's very important not to over-tighten the assembly, as this can cause a sticky feeling in the steering and not return to center easily. If this condition exists after the install, we recommend backing off the upper ball joint tensioner nut until loose and bringing it just back into contact where resistance is felt in the wrench as tightening. Now that all is to do is to go out and enjoy your new ball joints. Learn more, visit us at MetalCloak.com. MetalCloak, it's your Jeep, only better.